That's the Sonos?
Yeah.
Man, that's sick. That's nice. Need that for my house.
Yeah, I have a Definitive Technology audio setup.
Okay.
They have this. It's actually not bad.
No.
I have that actually at my house in Arvada too. The quality, the sound quality is badass. But I have a sound bar and a subwoofer.
Okay.
Just in a 1,300 square foot apartment. And it thumps hard.
So you need a sub.
Sub and the fucking, that, it's like a 7.1 channel.
Okay.
It's nasty.
Nice.
I mean, it's loud. And it works the same way.
Okay. It's on your phone, huh?
Yep. Halftime. Just got done doing just a couple sets of these. You can switch these up with dumbbells. But we just did some standing leg curls. Before that, we did seated, and then lying leg curls, but doing them unilaterally. And then what we started with was lying leg curls with both legs. So a few different exercises you guys can try. All right, about now I'm gonna now get my mind right for the second half. Get some quads in. I'm gonna start with some leg extensions and really just focus on more pressing movements this time. I'm usually having more method to my madness right now, understanding that each workout is probably gonna be a little different. So one workout for quads will be more squat dominant, different types of squat, back squat, front squat, half squat, super squats, whatever, lunges. And then the next one will be different types of presses. So a lot of instinctive training going on right now because we're 15 and a half weeks out, and I can still have some flexibility with my diet, but also my training. So just trying to figure out what I like. And then about 12 weeks out, next 3-4 weeks, I'll be stuck with those same workouts for the next 10 to 11 weeks. Right now we're just trying to get a lot of endurance training going right now because I want to kind of exhaust myself a little bit. It's almost like conditioning for other sports. Like, you gotta focus on getting your wind. Just focus on strength all you want and take 5, 6, 7, 8 minutes to do some big heavy stuff, but we're going pretty quick. Everything's within a minute, really, if not 30 seconds. And I'm just, like I said, just working on my wind. Being at this altitude, I can get a little bit extra advantage.
kid, I was always doing calf raises because I was always told that if you had good strong calves, you could run really fast and dunk a basketball. So I was able to do that, obviously, a long time ago, of course. But as I became a bodybuilder, I didn't train calves as much. But now I'm starting to realize like that's muscle that I basically had and just lost. So, you know, when you start thinking about it from a strength and weaknesses standpoint, it's like, all right, so if it's one of my strengths and I don't train it as much, it devolumizes and I may weigh in at a contest and actually be lighter. And I'm thinking, you know, what the hell's going on? It's like, Phil, you weren't training arms maybe as much or calves. And that could be a pound each limb that you neglected. So this year, not neglecting the calves, I'm gonna treat it as if I was some of these other guys that I compete on stage that pretty much look like they're standing on their freaking hands. and just got done doing some calves, some quads, and also some hamstrings. Play around with this one, change up the order. Rep range is usually around 8 to 10. On the calves, a little bit different. Standing calf raise is around 20. This seated machine, around 20 the same, and then this one, 15 to 20. And then the last few were 10. Try to get a lot of volume. I'll be doing a different workout on Friday. I usually try to train Tuesdays and Fridays now. Hamstrings, quads, calves, then quads, hamstrings, calves on Friday. We'll see how that all works out this week. But thank God for the Built, for Gifted Nutrition. I noticed during the workout I was able to actually stay focused throughout the whole workout and didn't really get that lactic acid buildup. And that really messed with my mind, even though I've been taking this for about a year now. Just realizing that I'm going beyond my limits. Obviously, it stands for beyond your limit training, but I'm going beyond the limits because I'm not being hindered by the lactic acid buildup. I'm actually experiencing more muscle fatigue. So in between sets, my recovery time is so much faster, where I could literally just live in the gym. You got to think I've done, four. Literally almost about 50 sets tonight, easily. And don't really feel bad. So that's always a good thing, especially being at 1 a.m. Don't feel too exhausted. Still was able to get my meals in and stuff, but I should literally be tired off my ass, running errands all day, doing the conference calls, answering emails from you guys, the fans, and get my mind ready to come in here, you know, and still having to go home tonight, eat, and then pack up because I get to go to New York tomorrow, well, on Thursday, and go do some crazy stuff out there too. So anyway, shout out to all you fans out there watching. This is The Gift. It's the dynasty going for